the way he feels and everything comes in. So when we talk about mental health specifically, it is an individual's healthy or a happy state of mind, you know, which leads him or her to do and deal with his life effectively. If we try to break it further, it is composition of emotional, psychological, and social well-being. So how comfortable you are emotionally, how comfortable you are psychologically, and how comfortable you are socially. It all consists of mental health. Mental health also involves, as I said, how you think, how you feel, and further how you act. Okay. Now, why mental health? We always get this question in our head that, you know, ki mental health se kya hota hai? I'm happy, I'm adjusting well, I don't need anything else in my life. But then the question is, are you able to deal with your life and your life issues throughout the lifespan? What I'm trying to tell you is that mental health is not only for people who are dealing with stress or depression or any sort of psychological distress. Okay, mental health is also for a normal human being to understand how he has to keep himself, you know, at a very comfortable level to deal with situations. So before we start talking about mental illness, okay, I would like to discuss about what exactly are the myths around mental illness. जब भी हम इंडिया में स्पेशली मेंटल इलनेस की बात करते हैं, ओ हो पागल है क्या, क्या हो गया, अरे इसकी झाड़ फूक करवा दो, यू नो, वी दो टाइम्स हैव चेंज्ड, वी आर गेटिंग मोर अवेयर ऑफ थिंग्स अराउंड अस, बट देन बीइंग अवेयर इज नॉट द ओनली थिंग यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड. ओके, सो द जनरल मिथ्स, आई फाउंड अ वेरी गुड आर्टिकल बाय अतिका शुक्ला, हु इज अ फाउंडर एंड सीईओ ऑफ ब्रेकिंग बैरियर्स. So, which more or less covers each and every myth which is present around us. So, the first and the favorite most of generally people, person with mental illness is possessed by ghosts. So, you know, any kind of distress is dealing, you know, if the manifestation is physical, if the person is getting any sort of attack, any sort of anxiety attack or something like that, the first reaction, especially when we talk about the weaker section, they will be like, ki isko to bhoot aa gaya hai, isko mata chad gayi hai, let's take him to the priest and he will do some, you know, perform some ritual and he will be free, which is not true. Okay, it is a very scientific kind of a state, mental illness, you know, you have all sort of neurochemicals which actually manages everything. So no, if anybody around you is showing you any kind of symptom, it is definitely not a ghost. A very common myth around mental illness is that once you go to a professional, he will start with medication and it will become addictive. So it's a very normal process, you know. I always tell this to my clients that even if you start taking medication for, you know, simple a painkiller, if you start taking for 4 continuous days, the 5th day if you stop it, there is going to be a little difference you will feel. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is ki whenever a psychiatrist is giving you any sort of medication, so he will make sure that he introduces this medication slowly and tapers it down slowly. Okay, so it is not going to make you addictive or something. The psychiatrist, I think, is capable enough to take care of that particular situation wherein he is prescribing you medicines and he can take care of it. So just don't stop taking medication thinking that, you know, you will be addicted to it. Now, a very common sort of myth which I have come across during my counseling career is marriage can cure a person's distorted thinking and unusual behavior. So, ladki na thoda sa akeli akeli reh rahi hai, thoda roti zyada hai, chalo iski shaadi kara dete, sab theek ho jayega. So, apparently, in Indian scenario, marriage is the, you know, cure to everything, and it actually works vice versa. Okay, so marriage is never an answer. All mental illness, all people with mental illness should be kept in a hospital. this point, and there is one more point I would like to talk together. The fourth last, treatment of mental illness is brutal, such as electric shock. Thoda sa, with due respect, I will blame our film industry for this, because whenever they tried to show a person with mental illness, they always tried to show, you know, zanjeeron mein bada hua hai, usko electric shock de rahe hain. Or some of the other thing, and they are, you know, the individual if showing some sort of behavior, which is a symptom. Let me be very clear, which is a symptom, but that person is dragged and, you know, kept inside a room in isolation and all those things. So it is a very big myth that every mental illness individual should be kept in hospital. Mental illness is a normal thing, as cold or fever, and it can be treated with medication and therapy. So you can very well stay home if at all anybody is, you know, diagnosed with something. And electric shock is now illegal. You cannot really give electric shock to an individual who is going through any sort of severe symptom.